Hello, welcome back. Today's topic that we are going to see in this video lecture is an resilient packet ring. It is also known as IEEE 802.17. It was defined by the IEEE. It is a protocol designed for optimized transport of data traffic over a optical fiber ring network. Means to avoid the congestion, it optimizes the transport of data. Main goal for resilient packet ring was to improve the efficiency of Ethernet and IP services. The nodes and stations in the in this are connected in a dual ring structure. It are connected in a dual ring kind of structure. As you can see in this figure, there are two different rings and both are rotating in opposite direction. Main aim was to reduce the traffic or congestion so that efficiency of Ethernet can be improved. So these two different ring, as you can see, there are two different ring, inner ring and outer ring. Both the ring are going to be rotated in a opposite direction, and these rings are called as ringlets. These ring are called as ringlets. Transmissions can occur along both the rings, and transmission can occur along both the rings, and this help to utilize the total bandwidth as compared to the previous token ring that we have seen in the previous lecture. Whereas in that case, what was happening, the data was transferring, data can be transferred using only one ring, and the second ring was remaining, was there for backup purpose. Whereas in this, both the ring can be used for the transmission of data. You should remember that one more thing you should remember: transmission of data and a transmission of control, as I have said, it can occur at both the rings, means it can occur at both the ringlets. But you should note that the control signal is carried in the opposite direction of data traffic whose information it carries. Means, for example, if inner ring is carrying the information, the outer ring is going to carry the information of control signal or transmission of control signal. Means both the things is going to be happen in a opposite direction, or you can say in a different rings. So there are some advantages why actually it has been used. Resilient packet ring has been used. Like you can see in this, RPR has some advantages, like it can negotiate with the bandwidth issues with other nodes. It can also handle, or it can schedule traffic or a data in order to their priority, which will avoid the congestion and minimize the failed transmission. So these are the advantages why the RPR is being used. In case any of this ring is broken, transmission can still continue with the help of methods called steering and wrapping. What is steering? It notifies all the nodes about the broken link, and they reroute the traffic. So this happens in a steering. Whereas what is happening in the wrapping? The data traffic is looped back at the last node before the link breakage. Link breakage. And it reroute the destination node via other ringlet so that the data can still be transferred. This is the way how the resilient packet ring works.